Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, it's a honor for me to welcome on behalf of the Portuguese government all of you to Portugal, to Estoril, for this important conference. I would like to say a special word thanking Frontex and Interpol for the organization of this, I would say, historical meeting, working for the first time together on this field. I would like especially to thank Fabrice Leggeri from Frontex and Cyril Good from Interpol for the organization of this important conference. Portuguese government is fully committed to work with Frontex, to work with Interpol, to work with other countries on security as a basis for a safer world, for a safer Europe. For Portugal, it's quite important on all international assessments, Portugal is qualified as one of most safe countries in the world. That's why, for us, this conference being held in Portugal is an honor, and we fully support the work you are going to develop these days. During my first weeks as Minister of Home Affairs, I had the opportunity to have a meeting with Minister Meng Hongwei, President of Interpol, during his visit to Portugal to attend the Web Summit conference. And also yesterday, I met Commissioner Dimitris Avramopoulos, and had the opportunity to discuss issues connected with migration and homeland security. This conference today is strictly connected with this important work of giving to the experts the opportunity to exchange experience and learn from the work previously developed from both the EU member states and third countries. In a world of massive and increasing global migrations, security issues gain an important role. The technical quality and the security of documentations regarding identity or travel must be questionable. Fraud on travel documents constitute a threat to national security and also to the space of free movement of persons in which we are proud to belong. Freedom and security walk hand in hand. One is not possible without the other. To fight the organized networks that profit from fraudulent documentation, the quality of identity and travel documents has to be raised even more, and the national systems of entry and exit have to be further developed and integrated, and international cooperation has to be strengthened on a constant basis. Over the years, Portugal has paid special attention to these issues. I remember 10 years ago, when I was member of another Portuguese government, the work we developed about the program SIS One for All. That happens, I should remember, during the 2007 Portuguese presidency of the European Union. That's why today, 10 years after that event, the participation of representatives of high level from both agencies and experts from different countries, as well as the discussion that will follow, including the visits to Lisbon Airport and to the Foreign Police Headquarters, will contribute to the success of this conference. Portugal is making this work. Even in other fields, I should refer, this year we adopted in the Parliament, after several years of internal discussion, an important law on the access of our intelligence community to metadata. And we are working now on a law about the passenger name record. Matters like this are strictly connected with the goal of this conference. That's why the only thing I should tell you is you get some time to have a look around, have a view of the beautiful sunshine. Even in November, you may have in Portugal, but I hope you still will be strictly focused on the matters of travel documentation fraud, and I hope you great developments and a huge success on this field of stronger cooperation between Frontex and Interpol. You may be sure Portuguese government will work hardly with you and with support all of your work. Welcome and good work.